أشرف المرسلين محمد بن عبد الله وعلى آله وصحبه ومن والاه. رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي أمري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقه قولي. أما بعد، أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. وقال الذين لا يعلمون لولا يكلمنا الله أو تأتينا آية كذلك قال الذين من قبلهم تشابهت قلوبهم قد بينا الآيات لقوم يوقنون. وقال الذين لا يعلمون، those who do not know about Islam, do not know about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, do not know about what's good for them in this dunya and the hereafter, they would say, لولا يكلمنا الله أو تأتينا آية. If only Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is to show himself and speak to us directly. And these are the pagans, the mushriks, the mushrikeen of Quraysh. Now we know from the Quran and from the Sunnah that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala does not speak to anybody and portray himself to anyone, because that is not possible in our current and our limited creation. As he says in the Quran, وَمَا كَانَ لِبَشَرٍ أَن يُكَلِّمَهُ اللَّهُ إِلَّا وَحْيًا. It is not for a human being that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala would speak to except by way of the wahy, meaning by the way of Jibreel alayhi salam. وَمَا كَانَ لِبَشَرٍ أَن يُكَلِّمَهُ اللَّهُ إِلَّا وَحْيًا أَوْ مِنْ وَرَاءِ حِجَابٍ, or from behind a veil, like Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala spoke to Musa alayhi salam. أَوْ يُرْسِلَ رَسُولًا فَيُوحِي بِإِذْنِهِ مَا يَشَاءُ, or that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala would send a messenger, just like he sent to Ibrahim alayhi salam, and other prophets and messengers. فَيُوحِي بِإِذْنِهِ مَا يَشَاءُ, that he would give with his permission, he would reveal whatever he wills. Add to that what was mentioned also at the tongue of Ibrahim alayhi salam when he addressed his son Ismail. قَالَ بُنَيَّ إِنِّي أَرَى فِي الْمَنَامِ أَنِّي أَذْبَحُكَ. Say, oh my son, I see in my sleep that I'm slaughtering you. So that's the fourth condition. There is no other condition that is mentioned in the Quran or the Sunnah or other ways that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala communicates with a human being. Now, the question is often asked by the disbelievers. And this is not a question that any believer would ask. Why, with the knowledge that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has, why did he create the kafir? Now, the simple answer to any question that is asked about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, as he says in the Quran, he does as he wills. And we as believers believe whatever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala does is according to infinite knowledge and infinite wisdom. So we as believers, we strive to address the question, what is the wisdom? What is the wisdom behind what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala does? The kafir always poses and finds ways to pose an objection to the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala did not create any disbelievers. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created only believers. Everybody, as the Prophet ﷺ tells us, everyone is created upon the fitrah, the predisposition to worship and have faith and conviction in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Everybody's been created upon the fitrah. Then his parents or her parents would either, you know, mislead them to Christianity or Judaism or any other religion for that matter. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala does not create a kafir right off the start. Now, why does a kafir become a kafir? Wal-iyadu billah, somebody decides to disbelieve in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is not an arbitrary matter that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guides some and misguides some. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guides those who've accepted the guidance of the Quran and the Sunnah, meaning that they've accepted that as the source of which has been authenticated. The divinity of the Quran and the Sunnah has been authenticated. The divinity of the Prophet ﷺ and the authenticity of his prophethood has been, you know, established. So therefore they strive to do that which pleases Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. As for the disbeliever, right off the start, as the Quran records in Surah Al-Isra, وَقَالُوا لَن نُؤْمِنَ لَكَ حَتَّى تَفْجُرَ لَنَا مِنَ الْأَرْضِ يَنْبُوعًا. We will not believe in you unless you cause water to gush out of the ground. وَقَالُوا لَن نُؤْمِنَ لَكَ حَتَّى تَفْجُرَ لَنَا مِنَ الْأَرْضِ يَنْبُوعًا أَوْ تَكُونَ لَكَ جَنَّةٌ مِّن نَخِيلٍ وَعِنَبٍ فَتُفَجِّرَ الْأَنْهَارَ خِلَالَهَا تَفْجِيرًا. Or that you would have an oasis, a garden, you know, on the face of the earth, that you would cause river to flow through this garden, and you would have grapes and fruits and so on and so forth. أو تكون لك جنة من نخيل وعنب فتفجر الأنهار خلالها تفجيرا أو تسقط السماء كما زعمت علينا كسفا. Or that you would cause the heavens to come tumbling down upon us. Look at the logic or the lack of it of a disbeliever. That if you're truly a prophet, bring the heavens down on our heads. يعني what kind of logic is this? As they say in the Quran, اللهم إن كان هذا هو الحق من عندك فأمطر علينا حجارة من السماء. Oh Allah, if this Quran is the truth from you, instead of saying, oh Allah, guide us to it, open our hearts to it, open our minds to it, no, فأمطر علينا حجارة من السماء. Cause rocks to descend upon us from the heavens. Where's the logic here? So you can see the words of the Prophet ﷺ when he says, and of course the list goes on of their demands. And even if you do so, you know, even if you do all of this that we requested and we made as conditions for our belief and stipulations for our belief, we're still not going to believe in you. That's why the Prophet ﷺ at the end he said, قُلْ سُبْحَانَ رَبِّي. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, قُلْ سُبْحَانَ رَبِّي. Mean all praise and all negations of that which is inappropriate and unsuitable and unbefitting to be attributed to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala may be attributed to Him. قُلْ سُبْحَانَ رَبِّي هَلْ كُنْتُ إِلَّا بَشَرًا رَسُولًا. Aren't I nothing but a human being, a messenger from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, a messenger of mercy and a messenger of guidance. So here we come to the statement of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam to have a better understanding when he says, As-sa'idu sa'idun fi batni ummi, wa-shaqiyu shaqiyun fi batni ummi. Meaning that before a person is born, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows whether they're going to be happy or they're going to be miserable. Meaning that whether they're going to be guided to Islam or they're going to be misguided by way of their own actions. كَذَلِكَ قَالَ الَّذِينَ مِنْ قَبْلِهِمْ. So those mushrikeen who don't know about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala or the sunan, and the rules and the regulations of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made a statement similar to the statement that those who knew, who are they? They are the Israelites that received the Torah. They asked Musa, Arina Allah jahra. Said, oh Musa, we're not going to believe in you, alayhi salatu wasalam. We're not going to believe in the Torah. We're not going to believe in anything until you show us Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala where we can see Him eye to eye. Subhanallah. Of course, يعني here Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, كَذَلِكَ قَالَ الَّذِينَ مِنْ قَبْلِهِمْ مِثْلَ قَوْلِهِمْ تَشَابَهَتْ قُلُوبُهُمْ. The common denominator between those who know and those who don't know is that their hearts are the same. Their hearts are full of doubt. They're full of disbelief. They're full of raiba and shak and so on and so forth. قَدْ بَيَّنَّا الْآيَاتِ لِقَوْمٍ يُوقِنُونَ. Thus we explain and show the ayat of the presence and the might and the perfection of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. لِقَوْمٍ يُوقِنُونَ. For people who have deep convictions. Deep convictions in what? In the fact that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is a true messenger of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So the source of which is authentic. The fact that this Qur'an is the divine revelation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And it can be verified by anyone. Anyone who has interest in finding the guidance. And مراحل اليقين, the different levels of yaqeen, as we read in the Quran, علم اليقين is that when we come to learn about the Quran, learn about the ayat of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, learn about the creation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, learn about the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, learn about the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam himself as a role model for us. This is علم اليقين. This is the knowledge of certainty. Then the next level is عين اليقين. عين اليقين is when we see things, like on Judgment Day, when we see the hellfire, and when we see, you know, paradise. But alhamdulillah for the Muslims, they never get to experience the hellfire حق اليقين. Allahumma laka alhamd. The kafir get to experience the hellfire in all of its details, and all of its agony, and all of its wrath. عين حق اليقين, meaning that they're subjected to the punishment now. We get to, inshallah, with the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, get to experience paradise, حق اليقين, that we enter it and we experience it. And we see Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in it. We see the prophets and the messengers. We see the righteous and the martyrs. We see all of the good things that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has promised, you know, the believers. And that is the level of حق اليقين. So the three levels are, you know, علم اليقين, عين اليقين, and حق اليقين. إنا أرسلناك بالحق بشيرا ونذيرا ولا تسأل عن أصحاب الجحيم. You are not accountable, O Prophet of Allah, to those who decide to misguide themselves, those who decide to reject the faith, those who decide to go astray and disbelieve in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We have sent you indeed, إِنَّ أَرْسَلْنَاكَ بِالْحَقِّ. This is the truth from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Even the disbelievers, the mushrikeen, the pagans at the time of the Prophet ﷺ, knew that this is from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And when Abu Jahl was asked, do you truly believe that Muhammad is not a prophet from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? He said, I believe he's a prophet. He said, then why do you fight him so fiercely? He said, تَنَافَسْنَا مَعْ بَنِي عَبْدِ مَنَافْ. We have competed with, you know, the tribe of the Prophet Muhammad ﷺ. إِذَا سَقُوا سَقَيْنَا. If they give drink to the pilgrims, we give them drinks. If they give them water, we give them water. We race on horses until we became equal. Now they tell us, we have a prophet. Where do we get them a prophet? Where do we bring them a messenger? So therefore, we're going to fight him until death. So you can see that the issue of disbelief is an issue of stubbornness. It's not an issue that someone cannot find the truth. You know, with the ample evidence, by way of what we see and what we experience and what we read and what we learn and so on and so forth, even spiritually, when we are confined to our own, you know, rooms, our own seclusions, we know that there's a creation. Even in a state of emergency, the moment that any of us go through a state of emergency and they need help immediately, and they know none can render this help as far as humans are concerned, they say, oh God, oh my God. So you recognize right there and then that there's a God. This is the fitrah. This is the fitrah that you immediately go into the fitrah and you say, oh my God, oh my Creator, oh Allah. That's why in a state of emergency, when you notice that there's a fire in a building or there's an accident or something, people do not say, oh Jesus, or Uzayr, or any of that, alayhi salatu wasalam. They do not say this. They say, oh my God, immediately. Because that is the fitrah. And then we touched upon the ayah, وَلَنْ تَرْضَى عَنْكَ الْيَهُودُ وَلَا النَّصَارَى حَتَّى تَتَّبِعَ مِلَّتَهُمْ قُلْ إِنَّ هُدَى اللَّهِ هُوَ الْهُدَى. We touched upon this one, you know, in the last session we skipped over these two ayat. And inshallah, in the next session, we'll touch upon, you know, the Qur'an and the magnificence and the greatness of this Qur'an that we as Muslims, and I say this, we as Muslims are missing out on so much that is in the Qur'an in terms of the wealth of knowledge. At a spiritual level, at a healing level, where a lot of us have undergone through, you know, terrible experiences, and they have difficulties overcoming certain issues and certain defects and certain even physical illnesses, yet we are failing to tap into the Qur'an for spiritual and physical healing. For guidance, a lot of us know the Qur'an at a superficial level. But when it comes to day-to-day transactions, we sort of like as if the Qur'an does not exist. We fall and we go back to the default of the system of the countries that we live in. If people are corrupt, we join them. If people are good, we join them. If the system says ABC, we follow the ABC, we overlook the Qur'an. We fail to tap into the Qur'an when it comes to our own families, and our own children, and our own, you know, moral code, that when we read it, this Qur'an is wonderful, and we are willing to, you know, put our, you know, 10 fingers on and say, this is great. And we try to convince that the Christians and the Jews and the disbelievers that this is from God, this and that, as if we are trying to convince ourselves that this is from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That's why in the following ayah, inshaAllah, we'll expand upon that, where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in Surah Al-Isra, and in this ayah, إِنَّ هَذَا الْقُرْآنَ يَهْدِي لِلَّتِي هِيَ أَقْوَمُ. This Qur'an guides to the best of the best. So any of us, as Muslims, deviate from the Qur'an and the Sunnah, they are worse than the Jews who deviated from the Torah. You know, all these stories we've been talking about with the Jews, and by the way, we're not picking on anybody, because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala speaks justly in the Qur'an about every nation, and He speaks justly about the Jews, the Israelites, those who followed Musa alayhi salam. As he says in Surah Al-Sajdah, وَجَعَلْنَا مِنْهُمْ أَئِمَّةً يَهْدُونَ بِأَمْرِنَا لَمَّا صَبَرُوا وَكَانُوا بِآيَاتِنَا يُوقِنُونَ. That from among them, we have made imams. This is what we aspire for. لَمَّا صَبَرُوا, when they persevered in patience upon the truth. وَكَانُوا بِآيَاتِنَا يُوقِنُونَ And they had deep convictions in our ayat, in the promise of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, in the meaning of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So we as Muslims, if we deviate from our Qur'an, we are worse than the Jews. And if we are guided by the Qur'an, then we are better than them. إِنَّ هَذَا الْقُرْآنَ يهدي للتي هي أقوى من أقول قولي هذا واستغفر سبحانك وبحمدك نشهد أن لا إله إلا أنت نستغفرك ونتوب إليك سبحان ربك رب العزة عما يصفون وسلام على المرسلين والحمد لله رب العالمين جزاكم الله خيرا السلام عليكم.